infrastructure. So if I go back to my SharePoint Central administration to take a look at sort of what's changed in the way that search is architectured, and you'll see that, you know, if I click on application management, there's still service applications, and I can see my search service application here. Now, to remind folks, I'm using CloudShare Pro VM here with 8 gigs of RAM as my development environment. So some of the stuff is already set up here, such as search service application. So if I click on content sources here, I kicked off the crawl, the full crawl, which took 3 minutes because I really just have a team site that I created last time with a file here. So that part is already sort of taken care of, and really not much different from what you've seen in 2010, right? So there's your search service application. There's some things that are a little different. I'm not going to get into those details right now. This is more of just an overview. So let's take a look at the actual search site. So as you'd expect, the search site must be created here. Like, it's not available out of the box. If I click view all site content, there's just a couple of libraries here. There is no search site. So if you try to create the search site here, you'll immediately you'll be able to create it and see, you know, from Enterprise Search Center, you'll see actual the template. But when you click create, it'll actually give you an error saying that the publishing infrastructure isn't turned on as a site feature. So you're gonna have to turn that on before that actually works for you. So let's go ahead and turn that on. It's a site collection feature, and it's a publishing infrastructure feature. Activate, and I also assume I'm gonna have to create I'm gonna have to provision or activate the site publishing feature. So publishing infrastructure, I hit activate, it's still showing me as not activated. So let me just refresh the page again. So here, those are sort of things that you would kind of have to go through to make sure that they're set up properly. Yes, it's still not activated, my publishing infrastructure. So I'm gonna hit again and see what's gonna happen. And it's now activated. So what I'm assuming is happening is that it's actually activating there on the background, but it doesn't give you any feedback or any progress. So it's actually just hanging there. And we probably could expect those things to be ironed out before the actual release of the product. So right now it's not released, so keep those things in mind. So if I go to Manage Site Features, there's probably a publishing feature here that I need to activate as well to ensure that my search is working. And here it is, SharePoint Server Publishing. I'm gonna hit activate again. And again, you have no feedback of whether it's been activated or not. It just refreshes after a while. Okay, so everything seems to be fine, now activated. So I'm gonna create a new, I'm gonna try and create a new site again. As you can see, there's much more apps added to the page because we activated the publishing feature. But we're not gonna look at those right now. And there's another tab for publishing, but in my case, I'm only interested in the search, enterprise search. So I'm gonna pick all the default options and click create. One of the things that you'll notice is that the language of SharePoint's changed a little bit. It's more informal, it's more friendly. So you probably could expect that throughout the product. So there you go. There's our search, and since my search crawl has completed, I assume if I type in a keyword, I'll just get the search result for that document that I have there, or text file on the team side. So it takes a little longer. I think it's just a matter of a first time created site, and things are just firing up there, and we're gonna get our results shortly. As you can see, there's right away the separation between people, conversations, videos, and reports. So those are kind of available as tabs before, and it's sort of the UI changed a little bit, but the functionality is very similar to this. We'll have a separate look at that. So here's my results. back. So one of the things that you'll notice is that it gave me the site and then the document. When I hover over those, it's very friendly sort of UI that kind of allows you to see some of the related actions related to this document. So some, one of the things that I've been asked like a million times is users want to be able to go to the library where the document is. So now that's available here. You can open a library where the document is versus just opening a document itself, which can be a simple document like this. So what else? There's obviously a function to send this. We'll take a look at it later, but you can also extend what you can see here in relatively simple fashion. If I hover over the site, excuse me, there's an additional sort of set of functionalities here for the site. So you can follow the site, open the site, and etc. And again, we can extend what options you're going to see here, and you can leverage that pretty easily. And some of the basic options also to manage your results. So obviously, I don't expect to find anything from people because there aren't any people on this machine except administrator, and our keyword doesn't really match. But since we clicked on it, it'll probably fire it up. And we'll have a separate look at more complete sort of environment and how a search affects people search and stuff like that. But there's definitely more integration in terms of how things are wired from a people perspective. So I'm going to click back on everything. One important thing to note here, well, you can't see it, it's still loading. There it goes. There's my people. I'm going to click back. Here it is. So refiners, right? So the refiners are now a little bit more visual. So if you remember in 2010, you could get something like that. But you would have to, you know, resort to customizations. Now those sort of a friendly filters are available here out of the box, and you can refine things. In this case, by date, right? So it's a range refiner, and you can pick the type of refiner, and there's some out of the box UI that'll change based on that type of refiner. So that's it. That's pretty much the overview of search and how it looks. And we'll take a look, you know, there's going to be a separate video on how to extend this. One last thing I'm going to show is what's sort of behind scenes in search website on search site, and it's pretty much the same things, right? So there's tabs, there's pages which represent particular person search, or the results of report search or video search. Basically just like in 2010, just